So let's blow up our sampling distribution a little bit. So we have three critical regions. The smallest one has a probability greater than this z-score of 0.001. And this z-score here is 3.08. And remember that the middle of the distribution, the mean, has a z-score of 0. Then our second smallest critical region is 0.01. So that's the probability of being greater than this value, which you found was about 2.32. And then our biggest critical region is 0.05. So that's the probability greater than a z-score of 1.65. The z-scores corresponding to these alpha levels are called the z-critical values. So we'll find our sample mean, calculate the z-score in the distribution of sample means, or the sampling distribution, and then look to see where this mean falls. Let's say it falls in the critical region, any of them. That means it's unlikely. If it falls out here in the green region, or the smallest critical region, we'll report the smallest alpha level, because that means our sample statistics are really different from the population parameters, and therefore there's strong evidence of an effect from whatever treatment was imposed. For example, say we take some sample mean from some sample size n, and then we calculate the z-score. So remember, we subtract the mu and then divide by the standard deviation of the sampling distribution. And let's say we get that the z-score is 1.82. We would say that this is significant at p less than 0.05. And that's because if we look at where this z-score falls on the distribution, it falls in between 1.65 and 2.32. So this z-score, 1.82, is somewhere in this red region, meaning that the probability of having obtained this sample mean is less than 0.05, but it's not less than 0.01. So it's only significant at probability, or p, less than 0.05. And remember, 0.05 is the alpha level.